Okay, so in this session, I will start from the previous class that was about the sorting algorithms. Last time we have talked about the three sorting algorithms that they are the simple one, the simple ones, right? So starting from the insertion sort, bubble sort, and selection sort, and we have already tried to implement these three kinds of sorting algorithms yesterday. And today, we will go to the next part, that is the merge sort, merge sort and quick sort, that I would like to finish them by today. So if I recall you about the three sorting algorithm, when we talk about the computational time of their algorithms, what is the complexity of the three sorting algorithms that we have learned? Can you tell me? Anyone here can tell me about the computational complexity? But we have to talk in terms of big O. What is the big O for those sorting algorithms? Do you remember that? Okay. The sorting algorithm will have the big O n square, right? Quadratic. Okay, thank you very much, n square, right? So they have the common complexity, right, for bubble sort, selection sort, and insertion sort, that is the big O n square comparisons. It's okay if the data is very small. For example, if you just want to sort 10 or 100 data, so it's not a problem, because if you want to calculate the sort, right, it's just like, okay, 100 times 100, it will be just only 10,000 comparisons. So that's still okay for the computation. But think about it, if you have 10,000 data or 1 million transactions, what should we do, right? It's very extremely high, right? When you use the quadratic complexity, right, n raised to the power 2. So in this way, you may have to find other efficient, more efficient algorithm in order to sort your list of data. Okay, that here we come to the next one, that is the we call merge sort. Today we will talk about the more efficient algorithm, sorting algorithms. We have two efficient algorithms, merge sort and quick sort, right? Both of them, right, starting from the merge sort, right, it might be easier for you to understand, but both of them, you have to know about the concept of about the recursion. Do you remember the recursive algorithm? Do you know how to do the recursion, right? So you have to use this here, right, for the merge sort. Okay, for the definition, starting from the merge sort is just a sorting algorithm that will use the concept or the strategy of the divide and conquer, right? And also we have to use the combined algorithm as well for sort the solution, the subsolution. So I want you all to focus on the divide and conquer strategy first. And we have divide and conquer. As it name, divide means partition or subdivide into the smaller element, smaller list. Right? If you have an element array, we want to sort them. So what we have to do is we have to subdivide this list of array, this list of elements into two sub array of maybe approximately n divided by two elements. Okay, it would be the best thing that you can subdivide into half, right? But if not, so just only approximate the half. Otherwise, you will get the inefficient algorithm. Okay, so first of all, you have to subdivide this list, the whole list, into two lists, right? If A is an array containing zero or one element, then it will be already sorted. So in this way, we have to subdivide or partition the array into smaller part, right? Like let's say half, right, at a time. And then until, if we can find that this array will contain only zero or one element, so we will stop, right? However, if there is no more element in the array, subdivide A into two subarray. If there are still more element, more than one element, so we have to continue subdividing into two subarray, A1 and A2, right? So approximately they can contain a half of the element of A, right? This is the first strategy that you have to subdivide, right? So in this way you will have the problem will be subdivided into the smaller problem, and that smaller problem will be just only the half of the whole number of element. And then the next strategy is the concur. What does it mean by concur? Concur is like to try to sort it, because it is a sorting algorithm. So it means that you have to concur the result or the solution. So concur means sorting the two sub arrays recursively using merge sort, right? So in this way, we have the merge sort, right? We just assume that when we subdivide into two parts, and then two parts will consume less time or computational time, right? So in this way, you will have the two strategy, divide and conquer, but you have to add up one more function that is very important in the merge sort. That is a merge sort function. That is to combine two. Okay, after divide and conquer, right, you will get the two sorted sub array. Okay, we will start from array A, okay, and then subdivide A into A1 and A2, but A1 and A2 are unsorted array. Then we will have to sorted A1 and sorted A2. Once we have sorted A1 and A2, we have to combine them, right? By merging the two sorted subarray of size n divided by 2 to produce the sorted array of n elements. Okay, this would be the result of the merge sort of n element. Do you get my point? So first of all, you have to understand the concept of the merge sort first, so you can understand how to write a program. Up to now, do you have any question? You can ask me. Okay, in order to make it easier to understand, I will show you in suppose we have this list, right? This A, right? We have the element, eight element, 8, 3, 2, 9, 7, 1, 5, 4. And then what should we do? For the merge sort, you have to subdivide into two array, right? Two half. Okay, like this. Okay, we have two sub array here. It could be A1 or A2, right? 8, 3, 2, 9, and 7, 1, 5, 4. And then we continue subdividing arrays, right? A1 will be subdivided into 8, 3, 2, 9, and 7, 1, 5, 4 will be 7, 1, 5, 4, right? And how many elements in this subarray? Two, right? So we have to continue subdividing. Okay, so we can get only one element for each array. So up to this part, what should we do? What we have to do is you have to sort two elements and combine them into a list. So from this example, you have 8 and 3. So you have to combine them into 3 and 8. 2 and 9, so we combine to 2, 9. Okay, 7, 1, and 2, 1, 7. And 5, 4, 4, 5. So this we call, we will combine them together, right, with the ascending order. And then combine to a list here. So we can have 2, 3, 8, 9, 1, 7, 4, 5, 1, 7, 1, 4, 5, 7, right? And then up to now, we will combine them by using merge sort. And then we can get the result. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. Okay, I have known that this image is missing from your slide. So maybe I will copy this to the group. Okay, if someone try to write down into your note, okay, I can give you a time. Let me explain this again, right? For the merge sort, it's very simple, right? Starting from a list of an element, you have to subdivide them into two parts, two equally parts, and then you continue subdividing until you get just only zero or one element, and then you combine them by using a sort, a simple sort, right? Mm-hmm. And then okay, in order to use the simple sort, right, you have to use, you have to write an additional function in order to combine two list of array. Okay, I will tell you later. Okay. Like this, suppose you have got this list and this list. So what you have to do is you have to compare the first element of the first list with the first element of the second list. So in this way, in this example, 2 and 1 will be compared. So when you see, you can say that 1 is less than 2. So you pick up 1 to the first element of the resulting list. Am I right? So and then the index will be increased to 4, right? So it will be the next element that is 4. And then you have to combine 4 with the first element because this list, the first element, the index has not yet increased. So you have to compare 2 and 4. 2 and 4, 2 is less than 4, so 2 will be here, and then the index will be increased to 3. And then 3 and 4 will be compared, and then, and so on, right? So you can have 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9. So in this way, in this merge sort, you have the merge sort, right? That will use the divide and conquer strategy. And you also have the next, another function that you will combine like this, right? The first and the second, you have to combine two sorted array together until you can get the final result. Okay, how can we do that? Okay, so you can see this. This is a recursive version of the merge sort, right? The input of the merge sort will be array of A, right? So we have the L and R will be the index of the first index and the last index of the considering array, right? And the output will be the array of sorted right, in non-decreasing order. Okay, so in this way, what we have to do is we have to find the, if A is more than one element, so you have to subdivide this array, right, into two parts, right? The first part by finding the middle point or the middle index between, in between L and R, left and right. So in order to find the middle, right, you can just simply use L plus R and then divide it by two. So you can get the middle index in between L and R indices. Okay, once we can find M, right, which will be supposed to be the middle point in between L and R or the middle index. So you don't have to do anything. You can just do the same thing, right? Recursive call, merge sort A, right? But starting from L to M, and then perform merge sort A of the element A, of the array A, from M plus one index to R, right? So this means that we will subdivide these two, the array A into two equally parts. Okay, two equally parts. And then you need to have another or additional function merge, right? You have to merge array A, right? From the index L to M and M to R. And then you can just simply combine them into the final solution. Okay, so this is just a recursive function. And I think this one is quite simple for you to understand, but maybe you have to be suspicious that, is it all right? Okay, it's all right, right? When you write a program and then you use the computer to do the recursive function for you, you don't have to do anything, just only try to define the merge sort. Okay, from this example, I can give you this one, this figure. Once you can see this figure is array A, right? Starting from the index L to R. And then once you find the middle point, right? M, right? Middle index, right? And then we have to sort, to resort. Okay, let's see this example. So if we start from, okay. This is when we have the two sorted array. We want to perform merge sort, right? Right. You know that from the merge sort, you have to subdivide until you, and then you combine them until you get the result like this, right? Two sorted arrays. And then, okay, the first array will be index I is equal to zero. And the second array, the index J is equal to zero. Okay, you have to compare the element or the value, right, I and J, and then you found out that one is less than two, so you can have one as the first sorted element. And then J will be moved to one, next one, and then two, less than four, so select two. And then three and four, is less than four, so K is now two, and I will move to three. I will move to two, okay. And eight will be compared to four, and then you can get four, right? Because four is less than eight. And then you can continue comparing like this until you get the final result. This is the process of the merge function, right? You have tried to merge two sorted arrays altogether into the final result or the resulting solution. Okay. So this is simple. So if you want to get the merge function, you can follow this algorithm, but you can just simply use this algorithm in order to combine two sorted array into one whole sorted array. So that's all. Mm-hmm. So you can try to implement this And this also another algorithm that you can use, you can also use. Okay, this is an example program in C, right? C programming that implemented for the merge sort algorithm, right? You can see that it's very simple. Why simple? You can just, the argument, the first argument is array, right? And you have to use to index beginning and ending, right? And then inside all of the local variables, right, it is declare, we declare mid, right? And if begin less than end, okay, you have to find mid, right? The middle index that can be found, can be calculated by begin plus end divided by 2. Okay, this is very, it's exactly the same as the previous slide that I have told you. And then you split them into two parts, begin to mid and mid plus 1 to end. Okay, you can split merge sort, right? This why we call divide. Divide into two parts, merge sort, begin to mid, and merge sort, mid plus 1 to end. But this is a part of divide and conquer. Conquer means you have to, okay, this is a conquer, right? You try to merge them together. This one will be subdivide, continuing subdivide until the array is 0 or 1 element. So, and then you have to combine them, right? Once you can get two sorted arrays, this merge function will combine two sorted array together. So we'll keep it into array and then begin, mid, and end, right? Followed from these three indices. Okay, this is a merge sort C program. And this one is a merging function, right? In C program. Okay. So now we have to find or to consider about the efficiency of the merge sort, right? Once I have just told you that for the selection sort, bubble sort, right, they have the what we call big O n square, right? That is not acceptable. Only the smaller number of the elements will be used. You can use those algorithm, but if you have a big data, okay, so you have to select merge sort or quick sort in order to sort, right? So and I can say that there are log n base 2 passes are performed for splitting another log n base 2 for merging. Okay, once you subdivide into 2, so you have 1 split, and then from the sub list, so sub array, right? You subdivide by 2, and then you can get the second part, and so on. So the number of splitting, is equal to log n base 2. Am I right? Okay, once again, suppose I have eight element, the first subdivision, you will get 4 and 4, right? Second subdivision, you will get 2 plus 2. The third element, you will get, the third part, you will get 2 plus 2 subdivision, right? And then this is true, right? And then the fourth pass, you get 1 plus 1. Okay, now it's 1 element. So you will have 4 times 4 splitting. Okay, for the 8 numbers of element. Okay, so we can have, if you have n is equal to 8, so you will have the log 8 base 2, that is about 3 plus 1, actually 3 plus 1, right? But for the complexity computation, you can just have the big O log n base 2 for the splitting, the number of the splitting in the merge sort. And then in each pass for merging, at most n minus 1 comparison are performed for our pair of lists. Okay, 1 minus n minus 1 comparison. So therefore, the complexity of merge sort will be n multiplied by log n base 2. Or we can say that big O is n log n. Okay, this is the efficiency of merge sort, right? That can be shown in the term of the big O n log n. Okay, what is the n log n? N log n is much less than n squared. Okay, I would say that. Okay, any question? Okay, now what I'm trying to explain to you is we are not going to use for the big data, we are not going to use bubble sort or insertion sort, right, because the big O is n squared. So we have to use merge sort instead. Merge sort is one alternative, right? With the big O n log n, okay? This is how can we prove the efficiency of the merge sort that I have just told you, right? This is a way you can follow the number of operation like this, okay? Or we can use this one, okay? So we don't have to try to prove, right? Because next course algorithm design, you have to prove merge sort with associate professor Dr. Peter Pon, right? He will teach you about the merge sort, and also you have to remember this, right? Because you have to see this algorithm again next term, right? And you have to prove for the efficiency of the merge sort in detail, right? This is you will be familiar with this equations, okay? I'm not going to prove this because my duty is just to show you about the data structure and the algorithm that will support the data structure. For in this case, right, we have to sort the list or to sort the array, right? So the most appropriate sort will be merge sort and quick sort, okay? And I would like you to do the in-class exercise, right? Uh-huh. So I want to subdivide you into a group of 5. Okay, what time is it? Okay, we have okay, we have 4 colors, right? So I will, okay, you have to apply primer sort to the list here, sorting, right? S-O-R-T-I-N-G, right? You have to sort this one, this, and then you have to show the algorithm and then count the number of comparison, right? I would like you to make the group of 5. Do you want to make a by yourself? Okay, I will, how many people? Now we have 60 people. We have to stop share. First, and then